Hey guys. Hey, welcome back.
Hey.
Matt.
Hey.
Milotovich.
Matt Sock.
Matt Sock.
Mad Dog.
Mad Dog Matt.
Matt Sock.
If this is your first time joining us on Signal Fire Radio, we want to welcome you. I screwed up the intro, so we had to do it all over again, and Matt and Evan were giving me looks, and I messed up our guest last name, and so just a little bit off coming into this intro. Plus, last time you guys told me I couldn't do my normal thing, so here we are. Welcome back to Signal Fire. If this is your first time joining us, we're so happy to have you. My name is Rob. I'm just a regular old guy talking into a microphone.
With a very defeatist look on your face. You're just like, all right, so
I'm joined by my best buds, Evan and Matt. Evan, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm super good.
You look great in that shirt.
I love it.
Yeah.
I love it a lot.
If you would like to get one of the shirts that Evan is currently wearing, and you can watch us on our YouTube channel, it's just under Signal Fire Media. It is the newest of the Signal Fire apparel and merchandise lineup. It's called the Combat Cocktail. It's our way of shaking our fist, I guess you might say, at the status quo of post-military service treatment through some organizations that would prescribe you, like they did me, uppers, downers, and opiates. We think that there are better alternatives.
Chills, not pills.
Chills, not pills, 100%. So the Combat Cocktail is available to you now. You can go to our website, signalfire.media/shop, and a portion of the proceeds of the shirts, of the sales of this shirt, goes to VAHA, which is the Veterans Alliance for Holistic Alternatives, and it goes to support the work that Chase Roth and I are doing up at the Capitol to get Senate Bill 711, which would approve medical cannabis for PTSD, as a treatment for PTSD, to get that approved too as well. So go get yours, Combat Cocktail, signalfire.media. Evan, you look fantastic in the shirt. That is the last plug I'll make for ourselves on this show.
But I do want to say, and because you brought it up weeks ago, and I had never thought about it, but you know, in the event that 7-Eleven gets pushed through, I love that 7-Eleven.
I do too. 420 or 7-Eleven?
Those are the only two. Come on. Yeah. Going into the legislature with Slurpees. But eventually we would like a strand, when everything gets pushed through, strand to be named.
Don't tease it too early. We're going to get there.
Yeah, okay.
We're going to get there. Right. We'll have our own marijuana plant called the Combat Cocktail or something.
Cannabis.
Cannabis plant. Cannabis. Sorry. You're right. You're right.
It's the appropriate term.
Matt, how are you?
I'm good.
You're doing well?
Yeah, man. Saturday.
Yeah?
Yeah.
When was the last time you went surfing?
Why do you have to ask when Valerie's here?
Because I know. Because we're going to talk
last
about
time
your surf
was when
snobbery.
I was in Florida. Or no, in California. So
you did?
Like a month? Yeah.
No videos? I saw videos of your kids learning to surf on...
I don't know what to tell you, bro. We were in San Onofre.
Foam boards.
You're like half a mile out surfing. You can't see anything. Don't get all judgmental. Go back to your defeatist face that you had a couple minutes ago.
No, dude, I'm back. I'm excited because we're going to talk to Valerie Bennett about surfing. Not to be confused with Valerie Brackett. Do you know a Valerie Brackett?
I don't.
No? Not at all? Go right up in that mic, or pull it up a little bit closer to you.
Okay.
There we go. Perfect. Technically, so you don't know a Valerie Brackett?
I don't know a Valerie
Brackett. I think I might have just made it up.
I think so.
Yeah.
Here.
Maybe you actually wrote Brackett.
I think... who knows? I mean, who knows what I did? All these notes are all over the
place.
Hold
on, let me check out my only social media that I have.
You're about to say OnlyFans.
Yeah. TK's been asking us when we're going to start shooting our OnlyFans.
I don't even know what that is, Evan. I don't know what that is, Evan.
We need that.
Exactly, 100%.
Set us out of the corner.
Everything is... Oh, you know what?
That's hey, there,
you're
there,
welcome.
There are Valerie Brackets out there. I have three that have popped up on my LinkedIn.
Do you know them?
No.
You connected with them?
Wow.
This is that opportunity.
Yeah,
yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
Start sending unsolicited third level connection requests to
blind
to all the blind Valerie Brackets of the world. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yeah. So you are a Marine Corps veteran.
Mm-hmm.
You did some contracting work.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're really involved with some nonprofits.
Yep.
Particularly One More Wave.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about the mission of One More Wave, if you will.
Yep. So overall, the mission of One More Wave is to leverage surf therapy versus, other alternative routes for veterans, to kind of be that bridge between once you leave that service, once you leave that place of camaraderie and friends and your family. And in that regard, when you leave the military, you're kind of left without anyone to talk to or anyone with similar interests. So it's kind of that bridge, right? And you use surfing as that form of therapy, that place you can meet together. Even if there's good waves or not good waves, you can still meet together and have a good time and kind of shoot the shit. Am I allowed to say that word?
We'll edit it out.
Shoot the poop. Okay. I don't know if that sounds appropriate either.
I love shooting poop.
You had one rule from the One More Wave people.
I know.
We're not even through the first segment.
I know. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
but they understand. Like, they get it because, gosh, we have weekly calls and they're always like, oh, this dog is so not. And they're just going, it's awesome.
How did you get hooked up with them?
Well, through social media, to be perfectly honest. I'd gotten out of the military for a couple years. I worked from home for an amazing company, but just kind of felt isolated, like just by myself. And once you're left alone for too long, you know, like that's not good. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how it came about, but I started connecting with, or maybe it started showing up on my Thanks a Lot Instagram with your algorithms.
Oh,
but
you have no idea the ads that are going to pop up on our phones.
Oh,
later
man.
Today.
Yeah. My goodness. Sorry in advance. Sorry for your checkbooks. But but in all actuality, yeah, I had followed some really rad people, and then it started popping up, and I'm like, oh, well, how do I reach out to them? How can I get engaged with this? And then slowly by slowly, I started connecting with all the other writers out there. But it was all on the West Coast. That's it. And we didn't have an East Coast chapter. And so once I'd gotten approved to be a writer for One More Wave and whatnot, Rob, I had asked him and Alex, and I said, hey, can I create a chapter here? Because there's nothing like that here. And they said, absolutely. So slowly, we've been building it since actually like right before COVID. Mm. Slowly, but now we have people driving in from Raleigh. Sorry, did you want to?
No, you're fine. Yeah,
we have people driving in from Raleigh. A couple guys. We have a couple veterans driving down from Virginia Beach. One gentleman came up from South Carolina. Yeah, all over.
Okay, this is humbling me because she has invited me to come 5 times.
You won't go because you won't ride East Coast waves.
Yes, I do. But I was like, I don't live in Jacksonville. I live in Wilmington. Surf City's like 40 minutes. And she's like, yeah, but dudes come from like.
Is that where you guys go to Surf City? Is where your meetups are?
Yeah, we go to Surf City. And it's awesome because the community there is so embracing of this. Like, they're just wonderful. Like, they'll donate coffee, or sometimes we'll get the local smoothie shop. They'll donate smoothies. So we always have food and snacks and everything. We try to make it a really family-oriented environment. So, yeah, they are absolutely amazing.
So no kooks like Matt up there punching people for stealing a wave?
Howley? More of a howley than a kook.
Back off. Definitely a howley.
Don't ever
definitely
call me a kook. I will slap you with my quiver of boards.
That never leave the garage.
Yeah, so. Just because they're there doesn't mean that you...
True.
Yeah. 100%. So what was the... So you said they had to approve you. What was that like?
Yeah, so you can go through...
not watch you surf and stuff, or...
McQuist. No. They want to make sure she can handle herself
exactly.
In water.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. I had to do a breathing test. No. Yeah. You just go online and fill out an application. Although I want to say for right now, they've closed applications just because of COVID. You know, they were... raising fund opportunities have been a little slow because of COVID. You weren't allowed to do a lot of things. So the funding is not able to be there to support creating these beautiful custom boards for riders, for veterans, basically. A lot of them are for adaptive riders as well.
Okay.
So that's the best part, too. So it's not like, hey, if you would be an adaptive rider that you can't get out there. No, absolutely. One More Wave will help equip you to do that.
You've seen Bethany Hamilton. It can be done. Mm-hmm. She's got one arm.
Mm-hmm. Still paddles.
Still paddles.
Yeah, well, there's amputees that come out and everything. I mean, it's amazing.
What's a typical One More Wave event like? And how often do they occur?
We have them every third Saturday of the month.
Okay.
We meet from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m., and reasons being, well, a couple things. But in the first hour is we do beach cleanup. I think that's the best way to kind of give back to our community. And if you bring children, which, again, I always tell them, like, hey, bring your kids. Like, if you're a single parent, come on out, and I'll watch them. Like, you go have fun. But it's a good way to also show our children, like, hey, we really need to take care of our beaches and our community. And then after that, if there's really great waves, even though it's East Coast, right, might be longboard conditions, but hey, we'll take what we can get. If that's the situation, then we'll go. And if it's not, we'll have coffee. We'll, you know, have a good time, meet some other veterans, like-minded people that have similar interests or similar experiences, make friends, and then we part at 10 a.m. And another reason why is because then you have all the tourists that come out and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So we try to get out of
Dodge.
The
real kooks.
The real kooks.
The shoobies.
I got my bodyboard at Wings.
It gets crowded, just like if someone's going to the gym for the first time. You know, if there's too many people, they get a little self-conscious. So this way, if we go early, no one's really out there.
That's the move.
It is. Yeah. And speaking of gyms, Matt and I now belong to Planet Fitness together. We're new workout buddies. That's a judgment-free zone, too, as well.
It is. I like they got that. They got the Lunk Alarm.
No, this is not a sponsored ad.
This is not a sponsored ad, yes, by the way. Yeah, Planet Fitness would like, for Signal Fire Radio, somebody to speak on your behalf. You're going to have to write us a check for that.
No, the Lunk Alarm, and I didn't know it was like a real well-known thing with Planet Fitness, but there's a blue, like, emergency light that spins, and it's basically for anybody that's being, like, screaming and dropping heavy weights and just being that obnoxious, you know, gym
being
person.
Being that guy.
Oh, yeah. No, and man, people sure just do their thing how they want to at Planet Fitness. There are some characters. Like, I can't tell you how many times we're working out. Rob's like on his phone. He's like, Matt, look at him. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him.
Look at the guy. Look at the guy.
What is he doing? He's walking by.
I think I'd want to go just with like pizza just because, just to kind of see what happens. Like how many people are going to record me as I'm eating pizza on the treadmill. It's just to see what happens.
It is a judgment-free zone.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I'm into fitness. Yeah. Fitness pizza in my mouth. Have you eaten like that?
No.
No? No. Why not?
Because gyms should be judgment-full zones.
Fair enough.
Oh, here it comes. No, here I just, comes I, the God. Gym
you know my gym alter ego is Sting. So I just, I sit in the corner brooding about the, you know, 400 pounds I'm about to put on my back. Yeah.
Where's your Atlas stones? Yeah. It's like, oh, Lord of mercy.
Oh, it's beautiful. So the next one's going to be August 21st. Is that right?
Yep.
Oh, we should go out, Matt.
That's the day before my mom's birthday.
Is it?
Yeah.
I'm in town. Is that when the... No, that's the next...
311 concert? Yeah, he's not going.
In September.
In September. Yeah. Val's going. Val will be there.
Yeah. And he already said that you can't go.
I can't go. My parents are having a 50th wedding anniversary. It's
thanks,
like,
Arlen.
Exactly. You should have brought them. That's what I said.
Who knew that 311 was going to be in Wilmington?
Me,
on the
I
same
know.
Weekend.
I know.
Like, I love that
I know. You
knew. We knew months ago.
We did know months ago.
They came out with this thing called a tour schedule.
Yeah. But 50 years ago, my mom and dad didn't know that when they were getting married. And they really should have had that foresight to be able to say,
they should
have. This could impact my son's joy.
Yeah.
In 2021.
Yeah.
Are you a big 311 fan?
I am.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I couldn't recite like words right now. So,
no.
Yeah.
Could you give us a favorite song?
Amber?
Okay.
Amber's I can see that. Yeah. You look like an Amber person.
How did you get into surfing? Did you surf before One More Wave or?
I would call it surfing what I did in high school. I think I sat on a board.
Floating on
a board. Yeah.
And where did you
get
where
a good
you,
tan, right? Yeah. So that's good.
Yeah. Where are you from originally? We didn't touch on that.
Yeah, Orlando. Yep. So
okay. Great waves in Orlando.
Fantastic. Blizzard Beach is one of the best point breaks around.
Some of the best.
Typhoon Lagoon.
Yeah.
Are you guys being facetious? Because I have no clue.
These are water parks at Disney World.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you not a big Orlando guy?
I've never been.
I think Orlando is one of the weirdest places in the country.
But it's always fun to be there.
It's fun.
Yeah. It's very fun.
But I prefer Cocoa Beach, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Flying in and out of Orlando Airport is always an experience because there's always dads wearing Mickey Mouse ears.
I was just imagining it's like just... A million overweight people like from the Midwest on vacation.
Yeah.
100.
Actually, there's a lot more Europeans that are very...
With tiny swimsuits.
Very pale.
Yeah.
Very pale.
East Europeans.
Yeah, and then they leave red.
Oh, those red, poor
red, like
people.
Your shirt red. Yes. Yes, they do.
So from Orlando, where did you first start?
Cocoa Beach.
Yeah.
Cocoa Beach.
Taking
Cocoa
some
Beach.
Trips out that way? Okay.
The Space
we lived,
Coast.
We lived... On the eastern side, so we live maybe 40 minutes from the coast. So during hurricane season, we all skip school, even teachers. You go out to the beach and you have some fun. But again, I probably just sat on a board more or less.
Where did you really start surfing then?
Out here at Surf City.
Yeah,
a couple years ago. I've done some really cool trips, so that's been fun. But really out there, and I think I just had again an amazing community that gave me the time and space to be like, but also I was super open and receptive, like, hey, I haven't done this in a really long time. It's like riding a bike and you haven't done it in years. Like, I may have forgotten some things. Let me know. Yeah. And they've been really amazing. And
which foot goes forward when I pop up? Back foot first?
Yeah.
Foot
and she just recently got
what's the thing called paddling?
I don't get
you
it.
Know, yeah.
You just recently got a new board that I've seen a picture of. Super sexy. Like, really, really sick looking board.
Yeah, a couple new boards. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, a couple.
See,
okay.
Yeah, I got to see this one more wave board.
Oh, it's beautiful.
If I Google it. Can we get one for our next studio that we can hang in there?
Ooh.
What
do you mean? Like, oh, one more waveboard just I don't know.
It's free pub for you.
That means
it
no.
is free.
Listen,
how about I get you a t-shirt and some stickers?
Hesitancy
I'll buy them
means
myself.
No.
All right. I'll bring the stickers.
Yeah.
We'll work it out. We'll have our people call you people.
Fair enough.
Oh, that's excellent. All right. We're going to take a real quick break. But before we do, Wilmington, North Carolina is the fastest growing area in the metropolitan United States. Because people like to come here and they go surf. Actually, it's scientifically proven, gentlemen, that the closer you are to water, the greater your overall quality of life is. Were you aware of that?
Jury's out.
Is this alluding, to our sponsor?
Huh? We are going to get to our sponsor. Gotcha. But gotcha. I think it ties in nicely with what we're talking to Valerie about. Yeah, the book Blue Mind by Wallace Nichols, and he's a neuroscientist. Mm-hmm. He figured out somehow, I don't know how, could be making it up completely, that being in, on, underneath, or around water is scientifically proven to make you happier.
The salty kind.
What about a river?
Yeah. River would work.
Okay. Yeah.
But not rivers through mountains near Columbia, South Carolina.
There's no mountains in South Carolina, Robert.
Man, did you see a river runs through it? That had a sad ending. That's what happens.
River Wild? That had a decent ending.
I don't even know what that is.
Ooh, when we come back, we're gonna talk Brad Pitt's best movie, because
we can go deep with that one.
Fantastic. Yeah, but if you are planning on making a move to Wilmington, North Carolina, because you want to be closer to the Signal Fire crew and One More Wave and all the great things that we have to offer here at the coast, you need to get in touch with our buddy, Garrett Huffman, the musical mortgage man, NMLS number 177-8213, but number one in our hearts. He can help with VA, FHA, USDA, conventional, all kinds of loans. Get in touch with him. It's Garrett Huffman at LoanDepot.com. Do not go anywhere. We'll be right back on Signal Fire Radio.
Recently, I was reminded why keeping the human element involved in what we do for work every day is so crucial and so important. It can easily become a transaction for us with what we do for work, but we are really dealing with people's lives. And recently, I had a client who was trying to buy a house, and the market is hot, just like we all know it is, multiple offers on every home. He puts in offers on three or four homes, and he gets beaten three or four times, and he gets dismayed, and he says, you know, I'm just pulling out of the market for now until it cools off. And that's fine, people do that. But his agent that was representing him behind the scenes decided, you know, let me still do some research on my client's behalf, because if we can find that diamond in the rough and we can find that right situation, it will still come together. So without stressing the client or doing any of those things, he started to research and he started to dig. And he found someone that was selling where, without going into too many details, the needs that the seller had perfectly met the needs that the buyer had, and this agent was able to bridge that gap and to bring these two parties together in a beautiful way that would have never happened had the agent just thought about this as another transaction. You know, but this agent kept the human element first, foremost, and focused. And so now we've got a buyer that's under contract that is absolutely thrilled, and we've got a seller who's selling his home in the right way that he wanted to do that's also absolutely thrilled. And this is only because this agent worked hard to keep the human element first and foremost.
Military veterans from all over North Carolina are rallying in Raleigh with their sights set on a new mission, supporting Republican Senator Bill Raybon's bipartisan Compassionate Care Act. The bill, if passed, would legalize medical cannabis to be recommended by physicians for 12 disorders and diseases. People like Marine Corps veteran and commander of American Legion Post 539 in New Bern, North Carolina, Elizabeth Hartman, believe that it is a treatment option that could be utilized in the fight against veteran suicide.
Suicide is the greatest threat facing our active duty military and our veteran population. You have heard testimony, and you will, from individuals who have lost loved ones. You have heard testimony from military leaders who have lost more individuals to suicide than combat. And you will hear, and you have heard, empirical evidence stating that the medical application of marijuana will save lives. I come before each and every one of you today and urge you to live up to the statement that North Carolina is leading the nation for veterans.
Other advocates, like retired Army Command Sergeant Major Matt Quick, have personally seen the benefits of medical cannabis when his teenage nephew was diagnosed with Ewing sarcoma in 2014.
For 5 years, he battled cancer. Surgeries, probably 20 surgeries, medications, so many medications. They were just pumped into him constantly. In 2018, as he graduated from high school, he was fading away. He felt he lost a lot of weight. He wasn't recognizable. Through his friend network, he started smoking marijuana. For the first time in years, he can eat, he can drink, he can hold down food. He was becoming the kid that he always was before cancer. He can play video games late at night again. That was a big thing for him and his friends.
Medical marijuana experts like physician's assistant Tim Pickett testified on behalf of the medical efficacy of cannabis and the wide range of benefits it is having on his patients.
My youngest patient is 18 months old, managing a seizure disorder with his neurologist. My oldest patient is 98 years old, managing the end of life. I have IT professionals who are able to get back to work with PTSD after serving overseas. I have mothers and grandmothers who suffer from breast cancer who are now able to eat and watch their children and their grandchildren after taking cannabis as a medicine. These are not individuals living on the outskirts of our communities, they're individuals within our communities.
The men and women of the United States military have proven time and again that there is no task too small or mission too great. Will you support them in this cause? Please sign the petition and let your representative and senator know that you stand with our troops and many other North Carolinians that are suffering and are seeking relief.
Welcome back to Signal Fire. We're having a fantastic conversation with our very good friend, Valerie Bennett of One More Wave. Not to be confused with her alter ego, Valerie Brackett, who's not into surfing. She's into something hardcore, way more hardcore.
Yeah.
We were talking about something that took the world by storm, the social media world by storm. Actually, let me back up one more step. I got scolded by Matt Nevin, rightfully so. Our very first episode that we did where we had a fellow Marine who was female in gender, I made the age-old mistake of saying FM, female Marine. And I'm trying to get away from that. And so we coined her as Hurrine, as a Hurrine. What did you think about that?
That's
Do you
good.
Like Hurrine?
Yeah, or just Marine is
or
fine
just Marine
too.
Is fine, too.
See, that's what I said.
Yeah,
that's exactly
fine.
Right.
Stop calling me a female.
Exactly my point.
My paychecks look the same as yours.
They certainly do.
Not good.
So back in my core, it was WM. It wasn't FM. That must have been like
which
a...
Which is worse, I think.
It is worse.
Yeah.
I think it's way worse. I think it's way worse.
Resounding much worse.
Resounding much. We have two Marines who are female in gender.
Are we allowed to call them female? We need to ask them if that's what they
prefer. I'm not going there.
Quit.
No way, Matt.
Hence why I'm not at the university.
That's a bridge too far.
That's why I'm moving to South
Carolina.
Bridge
too far. But we were talking about the TikTok video that the military spouse made of her husband. Why don't you explain it for the people who haven't seen it?
Anyone who's ever watched it just knows if I say he's a Marine, will know exactly with her fancy TikTok moves or whatever, which I don't understand.
And him standing there at parade rest.
Oh my gosh, what a nerd!
Yeah, he was either a gunny or a master.
He was a gunny.
He looked like he had a couple rockers.
He did.
Yeah,
it's unfortunate.
Maybe he was drunk when it happened.
He didn't look drunk.
Medicated? I don't know.
Could have been.
Maybe it was a cardboard cutout. Because I don't know how he put up with that.
Yeah.
Not a real actual human.
Yeah.
Well, we embrace new technology and new media, obviously. We want to reach the military community through this. But we do not endorse TikTok in any way at all whatsoever. Yeah. Or Reels. Have you watched any of the Instagram Reels?
I don't. Now that we have Kiefer, I deleted it from my phone because I don't have to do anything with
it. I know.
It is very alarming because you guys have both witnessed my older daughter, Ryan, who's 13. Breaking out
into
her, like,
moves,
she's like,
just
and it's like,
very
stop,
very
stop what you're doing. It's so awkward. I'm like, you look like you're seizing. When she does it now, I'm like, somebody call 911. Ryan's having a seizure. Like, what are you doing? She has this look like,
whatever, dad.
And I'm like, what are you? You look like you're farting.
Let me live.
But I love my daughter.
That's a perfect opportunity.
Okay, boomer.
Yeah, okay, boomer. It's a perfect opportunity to plug our fake Matt TikTok page.
Don't ever call me that again.
It's at real Matt Mylott.
Just because I was in the Marine Corps on 9/11 and you were freaking still at daycare.
Okay.
I was in sixth grade. Yeah. Okay.
Why do you get so salty about these things?
He called me a boomer.
If you'd gone surfing recently, you wouldn't be feeling this amped up. You know
exactly.
What I mean?
Exactly. Let's actually explore that. Let's explore that a little bit in the context.
The waves were good.
Yeah, they were good this week.
In the context of military transition.
Yep.
As you were getting out, you were picking up surfing more.
Yeah. Goodness. Let's see. I think about a year before I got out, I went and took a trip to Hawaii and surfed for the first time in literally forever, and it felt super weird. But yeah, as I got out, I started surfing more. But yeah, that whole transition was just super weird as far as like you're going from this very regimented environment to then now I'm working strictly from home and I have no one to tell me what to do, when to do it. And I'm like, but yes, at that point, that's when I started really getting into surfing just because, yeah, you leave your world of family. You know what I mean?
Belonging.
Yeah. And then now it's like, okay, now I work for a very corporate company, which is awesome, but it just is different and it just wired differently. And so now you have to be wired a little bit different.
Mm-hmm.
So, but yeah, surfing was, I always kind of joke, but I'm, at the end of the day, like I think for me as a parent, as an individual, as a employee, like it helped save my life and made my life way better than it is without. So.
How so? Can you explain that a little more?
Yeah, I live with anxiety. I don't know if I had it prior to or had it because of my deployments or something. But when I left, I just was different. Things just didn't always process the same. So for me, surfing just kind of helped be that even keel, help bring that inner peace. And like, it's funny because even, I don't know if it was COVID or what, but I don't even go to church anymore. Like I go and pray more in the water and I feel more presence of God or spirituality or the universe, whatever you want to call it. I feel more present in that moment surrounded by that amazing feeling or that power than any other place in the world.
Isn't there, Matt, do you know about Surf Church here? Have you heard of that?
No. Oh, I have heard about
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I only saw something briefly about it on social media, but I think that's they do actual traditional church services out at the beach and then they surf.
Yeah, I think so.
We got to find out more about that. We'll see if we get those people on.
They have those.
That'd be cool.
They have those like in a lot of places, I think.
Do they?
In the United States, yeah. Because I know they have that in California. And I would imagine they probably have it in Florida and stuff. But that's cool that they have one here.
Probably not in Orlando, though.
Maybe. At Blizzard Beach?
Maybe.
Well, they have Christian surfers. I know they do that Oceanside and whatnot. Yeah. They have like a little scripture, talk about something, and then they'll go out and surf. But Surf Church, I recently saw that.
How regularly do you go? Do you go surfing?
As often as I can.
Yeah.
Yeah, like if it's really good every day, I don't know. 5 days, 7 days a week, give or take.
The rain's been super gnarly, though. I feel like it's rained nonstop here the past month.
You're
going to
get wet in the water anyway, so it doesn't matter.
I know. As long as
there's not lightning.
Say,
you're
going surfing?
Matter.
It's raining. It's like, yeah, no. You're wet when you surf.
Yeah. But I do make jokes, though, because I go with this wonderful group of people and consistently, and anytime I first get my hair wet, I'm like, oh, my God, guys, my hair got wet. You know? Like.
But it'll make such nice beach waves, you know, the loose curls.
Well,
Matt doesn't know what you're talking about. Matt doesn't have that problem.
That's what you say, but then like I don't wash my hair every day if I go surfing every day. It just seems like not doesn't make any sense.
Gets a little gnarled.
That's an understatement.
Yeah.
Gets a little
rough.
You got
good hair color for dreads. I think you should just dread out.
I should just dread out. Yeah. I could get away with that. Yeah.
I completely stand behind this.
Yeah. I as well.
100%. So talk a little bit more, I guess, about the transition, specifically your military transition and how surfing really kind of kept you in the moment, I guess. Is that the right way to say it?
Yeah. Through my deployments and whatnot, I think we were taught in the military to just kind of keep it together and like compartmentalize really, really well and stay present and be mission oriented. And then once you leave, that's fine, but you don't have those little safety things. You're not always worrying about other people. And maybe that was just me. Like, I'd be kind of like the mother hen of always worrying about other people, so I didn't have time to take care of myself. But then when I got out, again, working from home 100% of the time, even prior to COVID, like, always working from home, I had that time to just sit in my thoughts and like, oh, man. And then I had some personal things come up that I think – just kind of set those things off, right? Like unleash those little boxes. So for me, surfing was, again, that bridge to just calmness, to know how to be able to process that, know how to be able to breathe and be like, hey, you know what? This is actually not that big of a deal. It's okay. I'm not going to stress out or sit in quiet. I'll go with my, go to the ocean and sit with friends and sit with my community. And so, yeah, I'm grateful for them, grateful to be able to serve, grateful to be part of One More Wave. Like each day, I just always think how blessed I am. So,
how have you seen that organization? Well, the act of surfing, but One More Wave. Like, can you give any specific stories of people that you saw that were like a big ball of anxious nerves, and then how that sort impacted. Of helped them? Yeah.
Yeah. Goodness. That's like, well, I feel like that's all of us. But a lot of veterans out on the West Coast that I am friends with, like, they have that, or whether they dealt with PTSD, whether it was military sexual trauma, whatever it may have been, that gave them the confidence and the space to have that bit of quiet, you know, to be able to go back to regular life, to be a parent, to be an employee or whatever it may be, or be a leader in their community. I have one of the guys that rides out or drives out from Raleigh, same thing. Like, I've had many conversations with him. Like, he does go through a lot of depression, you know, because of PTSD and whatnot due to his combat deployments. But like, he'll go and he's like, man, this is just so amazing. And he'll be on cloud nine for like the next 5 to 6 days. And I'm always like, all right, but make sure you come out. Like, yeah. You know, if you and your family want to come out, come on out. We'll make arrangements, like, you know, whatever. But yeah, I've seen that change people's lives. And I can feel that through me mm-hmm. as well, like how it's changed my life. So yeah, One More Wave is an amazing program. There's so many different chapters. They have one in Hawaii. In that group, the chapter lead out there, Tony, he's amazing. Nothing but wonderful things. He connected me with one of the guys that I surf with pretty regularly. This photographer coined us as the Breakfast Club. So if I refer to that, that's what it is. It's a group of us.
Matt went to high school with Molly Ringwald. I think
no
it's.
I did not go to. She went to my high school.
It's important to know.
I was six when she graduated
Matt,
high school.
Oh Matt, shut up. Matt and Molly. Yeah.
When, but she did go to yeah. my high school.
Original high school sweetheart.
Fair enough. Stood her up on prom night.
I would not. I would not do that to Molly.
Oh my God.
Go ahead. Yeah.
No, this. Okay. But basically, yeah, we have a Hawaii chapter all along the West Coast, Santa Cruz, an amazing chapter leads up there, San Diego. We have one here. We have a small community growing in Virginia Beach, which is awesome. Yeah. We have one in Okinawa, but I think that's like a hit or miss depending upon conditions and safety and whatnot. But and of course, there's other veteran surf organizations out there. Like there's Warrior Surf Alliance or Veteran Surf Alliance. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. There's Warrior Surf Foundation. I think that's what it's called. That's in South Carolina. And then the other one, I think, is in Santa Cruz.
Matt wants to know if there's one in Rincon.
Santa Cruz was my home break
yeah.
growing up.
Yeah.
I grew up in South Bay, so Steamer Lane is it's part of my DNA.
Yeah.
And if you ever surf Steamer Lane, it's like, I'm not going to... That's why I'm a wave snob. It's like every day it's head high, overhead, and just the easiest break with long periods.
Evan has a glassed, glazed look.
He's so disconnected. He's like, all this ocean talk.
I haven't surfed since 2012, so.
Well,
what did you think about it when you did it?
I did it 5 to 7 days a week.
Yeah, because he was stationed in Hawaii.
I was obsessed.
Oh, that's right. You were
at it. Oh, that's a beautiful place to surf.
I surfed probably every surfable beach on Oahu. Well, I loved it.
Why don't you come back August 21st? We'll all go up to Surf City.
Yeah.
We'll clean up the beach. We'll have some coffee. We'll eat some burritos.
He's so disinterested.
Yeah. So, hey, there's the
I'll make sure that there's burritos.
Can you make sure there's waves?
I'll make sure there's burritos.
She can
That's
guarantee
the one thing
one
I can
those.
Guarantee.
And yeah. the last, yeah. my point.
And by waves, you mean hair waves? Like, what are we talking
not,
about?
If it's like head high, then you might as well sup. That's all I'm saying.
No. I don't know.
Dude,
you can do some fun stuff on a longboard, though. Yeah. I know that may not feel norm, but I promise there's some good stuff out there, especially this past week. If you didn't go out
See,
this week,
I'm
it's
with,
a shame.
I'm with Valerie's positivity in
I'm
this.
Just trying to make the best of the
look
situation.
Look how closed off and guarded they are right
yeah,
now.
They are.
They don't do
his that. Disinterest in paddling out when it's like knee high, it is not. He's not upset. He's just not interested.
Not interested.
Well, you can That's push fair. Other.
I live
we'll
to get
push
radical.
Other people off. We'll help other.
I live
we'll
to get
help
radical.
Other dudes that Bodhi. Haven't done it before.
So we typically go out to Surf City every third Saturday because we try to be consistent. But I know in October we're going to go up to Hatteras. So the winter and fall months, I know that is not your thing. I have watched one of your...
I do not like cold.
Yes. But if I can help find you a wetsuit, right? Come on out. We're going to go up to Hatteras.
One of my really good buddies here in Wilmington, previously a pro surfer, Rob knows him, Carl Wallen.
Carl's my dude.
The most iconic picture of Carl Wallen was taken by none other than Aaron Chang out at Shackelford Banks, which is like super southern Outer Banks, and it was like triple overhead, and it was an Aaron Chang picture. It's so sick.
Can we find it?
Yep.
I'll show it. I have a copy of it on my phone, but yeah.
I think I have a signed one from Carl actually.
No, but dude, when I was in high school, Aaron Chang was like, he was the end all surf photographer.
Oh, that's
right. Like he took that iconic black and white picture of Pipe. Anybody can recognize it. You don't have to be into surfing, but I had Aaron Chang everything.
Gonna say one thing about Pipe and why I can't watch that movie Blue Crush because of the way that Michelle Rodriguez says Pipe every time in
what
that movie.
What does she say?
She's like, we're gonna go surf Pipe. I don't get why she's so aggressive saying
it's Michelle Rodriguez,
yeah.
Bro.
I know. She delivers every line
default
like that.
She braps a WRX better than I do.
Yeah, I couldn't get into that movie because she...
It was a kind of just, cheesy movie. And
it was
I had strong hopes for it. The Bethany Hamilton movie is way better than that.
Yeah, what's the best surf movie? Chasing Mavericks?
Oh, I love that.
Chasing Mavericks, good movie. North Shore, 1986. Like, North Shore was...
Of course, that was about Point Break.
Is that a surfing movie?
I don't know. It's a great question.
Yes, it is about surf. Yes,
no,
it is.
I wouldn't agree.
Yeah.
Endless Summer, Chasing Mavericks. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, Chasing Mavericks, obviously, it's Santa Cruz. That's where they live. So. Just, come on.
Yeah. He can't help himself. He's got
isn't
to bring
it
back
of,
to Santa Cruz.
Isn't it north of Santa Cruz, technically?
Ooh. Half Moon Bay is north of Santa Cruz.
Ooh. Wasn't it Mavericks north of?
Yeah, but they lived in Santa Cruz.
Somebody
so
get
it's
a map.
Different.
That's all
so
I'm
it's
saying.
Technically different.
Somebody get a map. We need a geographer and a cartographer in here. We're going to sort all this out.
Get some tapos.
We're going to take one more real quick break. But first, before we do, we have to shout out our boy Garrett Harrell, president of Southern Cross Leadership Solutions. If you are somebody who has a team and you want them to be a little bit better than what it is that they are, what they are right now, oh, dude, Garrett's going to fire us after all this.
For sure.
I'm sorry, Garrett. If you have a team and you want them to be a little bit better than what they are right now, you should get in touch with Garrett from Southern Cross Leadership Solutions, friend of the show, former guest, fantastic guy. He's going to help you build better leaders who build better teams, who build better communities. Get in touch at SouthernCrossLeadershipSolutions.com. Do not go anywhere. We'll be right back to finish this up with Valerie Bennett on Signal Fire Radio.
The explosion hit. I lost consciousness. There was another soldier. He was directly under the blast. And when I was doing my check for casualties, that's when I found him. I hadn't had to see anything like that up until that point. And that is the one thing that I see on a regular basis is this kid. He was 19 years old. My name is James Rodriguez. I'm a veteran from Fayetteville, North Carolina, and I support the Compassionate Care Act, Senate Bill 711. One deployment story completely changes a veteran. They don't feel like they have any other options a lot of times, and when they feel like they're alone, they have no reason to go on. The VA had me on 12 different medications, and that's exactly what I used to attempt suicide. Medical cannabis has been able to treat so many different symptoms of my PTSD. Everyone has different symptoms and different ailments. North Carolina as a whole can benefit from medical cannabis.
I need to step into that. I think I'm the one who said this. I think this might be a Brad Caldwell original.
Okay.
But I just don't have the confidence because someone's going to say, you know, Brad, if you Google that, someone's been saying that for 200 years.
Yeah.
But it's whatever grows is from whatever is planted. So mind the seeds.
Ooh.
And I think more often than not in business, we grow and develop what we plant.
Mm.
And now we'll get frustrated because we'll shout that we want the fruit tree and get mad at the weeds.
Yeah.
But the weeds more often than not, as opposed to your yard in your life, they actually come from something you've planted.
Mm.
You know, we'll justify it. Well, I'm not good at time management.
Mm.
It's so hard to eat healthy. I got to get my however many hours of sleep in. I need me time. Mm-hmm. I don't want to work that many hours. Mm-hmm. Whatever it is, those weeds are also seeds that we plant. Mm-hmm. And it also allows a proper mindfulness that the greatest growth. Now, if I'm planting tomatoes, tomatoes is what's going to grow. Mm-hmm. But the watering, the fertilizing, the cultivating, the soil that it's placed into, most of that stuff doesn't have anything to do with me. It came from something or someone else. And so, yeah, I try to be as mindful as possible that the seeds are in my control. Mm. And in due season, they'll grow.
What we sow, we reap.
Right. And so I'm very cognizant of the seeds. So whatever grows is from whatever has been planted. So mind the seeds.
Welcome back to our third and final segment. You know what I love about this show is it's becoming more like not, we don't have like groupies, but we have a lot of extra people in the room and stuff. And it's, yeah, Matt shaking his head. Yeah, we have groupies now. Matt.
Yeah, our aunts.
Yeah, our aunts.
Our moms. Yeah. Our daughters.
Yeah. It's funny because I get mess because I manage all of our social media pages now, for now, until Kiefer takes them
over.
Oh,
wow. That was kind of a pretentious statement.
Yeah. No.
You're carrying the load for the team, bro.
It's been that way the entire time. So, I mean.
Dude. We need to be saying dude more. Dude, this is the One More Wave episode. Yeah. Dude.
Clearly, I'm the John Lennon in this, and I mean, you guys are.
Paul McCartney.
Paul and
I'm for sure
Paul
Ringo.
And Ringo. Yeah.
You're George Harrison.
Well, no. TK, I think, would have to be George Harrison because. Most people.
He's the only one with any talent.
He's the only one with any talent, right? Exactly. That George Harrison was the only one in the Beatles that was worth anything.
Ah,
was
come on, dude. Good. Paul McCartney did a lot of great stuff.
Hold your hand.
Anyways,
he's got to answer for that awful Christmas song. Still to the.
Don't even do it.
God, bro. You are so
too
right.
Early for Christmas.
It's the worst don't Christmas song that's ever been made ever, and Paul needs to answer.
No, Mariah Carey, dude. Mariah Carey's right behind that.
Oof. But she's not a
Beatle. I put all
Christmas music in the same category. Okay. And that's the garbage bin.
It's because really? It's because he's a pagan, though.
It's not because of that. I believe in Jesus, but Jesus didn't celebrate Christmas. That's
true. He did that not. Is so
we
true.
Celebrate Christmas because
he didn't
of Jesus.
Celebrate it with silver bells.
Yeah.
Or, thanks a lot, Bing Crosby.
Or myrrh. Or myrrh.
Yeah.
That's what we were talking about the other day, myrrh.
As we get closer to the holidays, we have to have like how commercialized the holidays have become because it drives me absolutely
it's
crazy. It's so.
I think they already put out Thanksgiving stuff.
What?
Yeah, or Halloween things.
If you go to Costco in August, there's like,
Christmas
stuff.
This is stressing me out. Let's go surfing.
Yeah.
It's sacrilegious.
Right. We're off the air. We're done. We're going to go surfing. What were we talking about on the break that we were going to talk about during this third and final segment? Does
surfing?
Remember?
Surfing?
We were definitely going to talk about surfing.
Oh, man. We are three very ADHD Marines and one level-headed Army
Ocean
operator.
Fest?
Yeah.
Are we talking about Ocean Fest?
If you want.
Is that a One More Wave thing?
No, it's not a One More Wave
thing. It's Ocean Fest, put on by Poseidon himself.
By the god of the sea with his... What now, is Neptune or Poseidon the god of the sea?
Isn't one Roman and one Greek?
Yeah, I believe so.
We got Poseidon.
I like Poseidon because...
Confirmed.
Poseidon? Yeah. Poseidon's the one? Well, then who the heck is Neptune?
One's Greek, one's Roman, and then you got the Norse god of the sea, which is Nord.
Oh,
and everybody's got their own thing.
Who's Odum?
Odum?
Yeah.
Is that Odum? Lamar Odom was
a terrible basketball player for the Trailblazers.
Who OD'd at the Bunny Ranch? It's in Odum. Henderson,
Odum is
Odin, the All Father.
That's what I meant. Odin.
Let's.
We'll
what
get,
did
we'll
I say?
Continue.
Let's keep moving.
Okay.
What did I say?
Odum.
Odom.
Oh, ODOM. Josh, please mute Matt's mic for the remainder of the episode.
Don't tell him that. We'll make him think it's muted. Unplug his guitar.
Yeah, no, it's like what I do with Madeline when I want to play PlayStation. I give her an unconnected controller, and she thinks that she's the computer generated players or whatever.
That is smart, actually.
Pretty brilliant. Yeah.
Matt, you're wearing a hat with a Valknut on it, and you just said Odom.
I thought it was Valknut.
Sure. It's whatever you want. Stop. It's whatever you want.
I also figured out why I was calling you Brackett, Valerie Brackett.
Why?
Because our next guest is Alex Stockman Brackett. And
there
so
it
I
is.
Took two and I confused them and I stuck it.
Oh,
together.
I thought you were like an FO and that was your thing. You bracket.
Bracket targets. Yeah.
Walk them on target. Think, getting tighter.
No.
Fire for effect.
No.
Triangulate.
Not at all. All right. So Ocean Fest.
Yeah.
October.
Yeah. It's
You're gonna be there.
Yes.
We're going to come.
Is it better than Burning Man? Because I've been to two of them.
Ugh. Have you ever heard this story? Matt, tell the story.
Okay, very quickly. Burning Man. Burning Man is like the festival of like the gods, almost, in my eyes. The most artistic. Odom. God.
This poor guy.
I admit, that was horrible. No, but I went down there with a group of my skydiving buddies in California, and we punched out at 16,000 feet and swooped right into the middle, both years, right into the middle of 200,000 people. No, it was more than that. It was like 500,000 people.
Why? That's the only question I have.
Because it was Burning Man?
Yeah. Because NAR. Mean,
yeah, it was NAR.
And I was wearing a helmet and silkies. No shoes, no shirt, just my rig, silkies, helmet.
Black silkies. Yeah. Woody green silkies. What a man.
Black.
What a man.
Yeah. And I didn't really know what I was getting into. And I was a cop at the time. And I very quickly was like, whoa, this is a questionable environment for me to be. And I'm
just like. Did you then walk on the hot sand, three quarters naked afterward?
Yeah, it's in the desert, right?
It's in different places. It's in different places all the time. Ours was out. It was about probably an hour and a half from Palm Springs.
Did you just step in everyone's rubbish on the way out barefoot? Mm-mm.
No, we left the day before it ended, but they did a pretty good job of keeping
it. Was this like a sponsored thing, or you and your buddies were just like, hey, let's go skydive into Burning Man?
Nobody down on the ground knew that we were jumping out. And I actually have a picture on my phone of my buddy.
What was your assessment of the people on the ground? Like, were they freaking out?
No. Everybody
were all high on Molly. So.
Everybody was cool. But like, I landed, I'm like, I felt like I fell into like a Star Wars set. It was just like, I knew nothing about it. And I was just like, wow, this is just...
It's like the Mad Max version of Coachella.
Totally.
Yeah,
totally.
That was the beginning of Mad Dog Milotovic's wonkism.
I think that was when I started... Festival. I think it was when I started actually chilling out.
Really?
Because I was still a little, like, aggro, Matt. Well, I still am, but anyways.
You're getting better, though.
I am.
Maybe we should get more involved with One More Wave.
I intend on it, and especially now that I'm only... 40 minutes away instead of 4 hours away in Bob Beach or something.
Yeah, we got like 5 or 6 minutes left. So Valerie, if somebody wants to get involved, like what are the needs of the organization and how can we assist or people that might be listening to this assist?
Well, there's a couple different ways, honestly. If someone feels like they want to donate towards the organization to help be able to provide equipment, whether it's regular surfboards or wetsuits, all the small things, right? Like all those small things matter. Gloves.
Small things.
Oh, sorry.
Too soon, man.
Yeah.
Mark Hoppus is fighting for his life right now. Oh. I don't. He's got stage four cancer.
Oh,
yeah.
No way.
Yeah. I can't imagine. I've already come to grips with Tom DeLonge no longer being in the band. But if a world without Mark Hoppus, I'm not ready for it. So.
Yeah. Kenny Hooplock can hit the ground running and fill that void.
Not blink. Go ahead. Sorry.
No Matthew, worries.
Don't hijack her.
Yeah, no. But yeah, funding is definitely always needed because that helps be able to build more boards, whether it's a custom board for an adaptive rider or if it's just a board for someone like you and I, right? Like those things are needed. Or wetsuits because, yes, the winter is coming, all jokes aside. But so that's always huge. If someone wants to get involved and like maybe they don't have money, additional money to just be spending on something like that, maybe just come out. Like come out and hang out with us, like build that community or really – if it's a veteran and they live near the water, whether it's here, and I forget, there's also a Texas chapter. I always forget about them.
Ooh, great break. Sal Padre. Yeah.
Corpus Christi?
Well, I'll come back.
Okay.
I know one's there. I can't think of the name of it in this moment.
Those are the only two
places
in Texas I know that are on the coast. So.
Yeah. But yeah, even if they know a veteran that's maybe slowly losing their way a little bit, they want to see if this is that platform, that thing that will help them. Tell them.
Yeah.
Have them come out. Like, there's no cost associated, like, whatsoever. Just come out. All I'm asking of you is just to come out. If you have family, bring them out.
Right.
There's always food, snacks, you name it.
So if I am that veteran or that, active duty member who's transitioned and I want to be a part of, like, a participant in this, what should I do?
Come on out. Whether it's they can reach out to me, they can go on to onemorewave.com, find their local chapter, throughout the United States or Hawaii or Okinawa. But yeah, they can reach out to me personally if they want. I'll give you my Instagram handle or whatever. But come on out because the worst thing you did is that you didn't go.
Right.
So there's literally, and it's not just like a Marine thing, right? So there's Marines, Army, Navy, not a Coast Guard that I know of.
Really?
Not at my chapter.
Anybody from the Air Force?
Is that a thing?
What about Eagle Scouts?
What about what about the Space Just kidding. Force? Does anybody from the Space Force, do they qualify? There can't be a single Space Force veteran yet, right?
It just hasn't started. I don't think so. Yeah.
Dude, I will say that when we were down in Cocoa Beach back in June, the Air Force Base right there in south of Cocoa Beach, it's crazy seeing signs that say Space Force. It's like you feel like you're on a movie set. You're like, this is a thing.
Real?
It's cool, though. I don't know. I wouldn't mind being in the Space Force.
No. I was thinking about
going back. Just to say you're in the Space Force.
Sorry, guys. I'm going to the Space Force. There's got to be, I would think, I don't know, I'm going to make an assumption here, that there's going to be people who won't go because they're nervous that they don't know how to surf. What do you say to somebody like that?
I would say...
Don't be a loser?
No, I wouldn't say that. That's for sure. I may think it internally. No, but all jokes aside, come on out, because literally there's everyone from different levels of abilities, right? Like there's some that will surf right next to the pier, and then there's some that are off to the left with the soft top. Like we literally have everything there waiting for you. Just come.
If you don't know how to surf, you got to kind of get a free lesson or something too while you're there?
Yeah, we'll help show them the ropes, like the baby steps, but obviously like maybe the main thing is to know how to swim. Maybe that should be the bare minimum. Right.
Come prepared to swim.
Yeah.
We can't teach you that.
Right.
Teach you how to surf.
Exactly.
Yeah.
There'll be someone there with them. And again, if they're a single parent, please come out. I will watch her. Well, if you want to participate, right? Like bring your kids. My daughter's always hanging out there. We'll have some fun. So.
I love it. What's your Instagram handle so people can follow you and get in touch with you?
Oh goodness. Okay, so
do
it's
it
long.
For the gram.
Yeah, _Valerie_Nicole, but the I is one, and that's it.
Mm.
See, it's just a lot. So
we'll put it in the notes.
Yeah, thank you.
Put it in the notes. Yeah, yeah. All right, awesome, Valerie. Thank you so very much for being here.
No, I'm grateful. Thank you.
Appreciate what you're doing with One More Wave. It's a fantastic organization. I'm glad we were able to finally connect with you because we've been talking about Matt has sent. Hey, we got to get Valerie Bennett on like 8 times. I think
she was on. I got connected with her through Ashley Chapman.
Yeah,
because she was on their podcast.
My good friend Ashley Chapman.
My good friend Ashley Chapman.
Post session podcast. Yeah. My really good friend. I've known her forever. She's fantastic.
Shut up.
Matt hates speaking because I hijack his friends. Mm. And I'm like, oh, yeah, no, I know them.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
No, that's called
friend
jacking.
Friend jacking?
Yes.
Careful. Could be something completely different.
Yeah.
Josh likes it.
Stealing friends.
10-12. 10-12.
I love it. All right, Valerie, thank you so very much for being here. Matthew, any final parting thoughts before we break?
Paddle out.
Yeah.
No, before you go. No, she has definitely helped start to reignite a flicker of flame for me to paddle out on just an average day here in Coastal Carolina.
Did you hear that?
That was alliterative. Yeah.
It was.
Yeah.
Very alliterative.
Yeah.
Flicker of flame to paddle back out.
Was it collegial?
Colloquial?
Colloquial. Isn't collegial
it's almost as bad as Odin.
Yeah.
Shut up. Odin. I meant Odin.
Oh. All right, Matthew.
It's so good.
Till Valhalla. We'll see you next time. How about you, Evan? Anything you want to say?
Yeah. I want to say that Matt sucks at mythology.
Yep.
And thank you, Valerie, for just doing what you do. It's super cool when there's, ways for veterans to deal with things other than what's thought of as traditional. Like, I don't want to go to the range anymore. Some people like that, but I don't want to. You know, some people want to do things that are connected to the military, but the nice thing about surfing is that like in no way is it connected to the military. Mm-hmm. So it's something brand new, and it's cool. It's great.
We gotta find a way to come up with a t-shirt design so we can sell that t-shirt and donate the profits to One More Wave.
Yeah,
because like this one is like going to Talon's Reach. That one's going to Vaha. We'll work on it. Our designer's pretty killer. Do you like this one? What do you think about that? We put a lot of thought and effort into this.
That is pretty cool.
Yeah, it's very
good
surf,
play on words.
Surf vibey, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think after you leave the military, you just got to calm down big time. Yeah. And being near the beach is the best place to be.
Chill switch, engage.
Yep.
That's it. I lied. I said I was only going to plug this once. I plugged it twice. Here we go. Yeah.
Here we are.
That's going to do it for us here on this episode of Signal Fire Radio. Thank you so very much for listening. And until next time, go feed your mind. Go strengthen your body, go enrich your spirit, buy surfing, and go grow your tribe, and go be a signal fire in your community. We will talk to you next week.
I just didn't want to feel any pain anymore. I mean, I'm literally like drunk, dug my own grave, and then like, who the heck's gonna bury me? You know, I'm gonna be in this grave and dead, and they're gonna find me. So that's not what I wanted. I just wanted to disappear and, you know, get by without having to be depressed. My name is Samuel Roberts. I'm a veteran and I'm an advocate for medicinal cannabis. In my first semester of my second attempt at college, I was struggling quite a bit. One day I'm in the Veterans Center at Cape Fear Community College and I was having a bad day. And a veteran, a Marine Corps veteran, walked up to me and he said, "Hey Sam, how you doing?" And just gave him the same line I always give everybody. "Oh, I'm fine, you know, what's up?" And he goes, "Well, you don't look fine." And we got to talking about it a little bit more, and he asked me, "Well, have you ever tried this?" And he was referring to medicinal cannabis. I had tried the meds, I had done the antidepressants, I had the therapy, I had gone to two hospitals, I was in behavioral health units, begging for help in all the legal ways. This was the only thing that I had to do, which would break the rules, but could help me. Speaking from the veteran community, we're losing 22 veterans every day to suicide. We need every weapon, every tool at our disposal to stop this.
Military veterans from all over North Carolina are rallying in Raleigh with their sights set on a new mission, supporting Republican Senator Bill Raybon's bipartisan Compassionate Care Act. The bill, if passed, would legalize medical cannabis to be recommended by physicians for 12 disorders and diseases. People like Marine Corps veteran and commander of American Legion Post 539 in New Bern, North Carolina, Elizabeth Hartman, believe that it is a treatment option that could be utilized in the fight against veteran suicide.
Suicide is the greatest threat facing our active duty military and our veteran population. You have heard testimony, and you will, from individuals who have lost loved ones. You have heard testimony from military leaders who have lost more individuals to suicide than combat. And you will hear, and you have heard, empirical evidence stating that the medical application of marijuana will save lives. I come before each and every one of you today and urge you to live up to the statement that North Carolina is leading the nation for veterans.
Other advocates like retired Army Command Sergeant Major Matt Quick have personally seen the benefits of medical cannabis when his teenage nephew was diagnosed with Ewing sarcoma in 2014.
For 5 years, he battled cancer. Surgeries, probably 20 surgeries, medications, so many medications. They were just pumped into him constantly. In 2018, as he graduated high school, he was fading away. He felt he lost a lot of weight. He wasn't recognizable. Through his friend network, he started smoking marijuana. For the first time in years, he can eat, he can drink, he can hold down food. He was becoming the kid that he always was before cancer. He can play video games late at night again. That was a big thing for him and his friends.
Medical marijuana experts like physician's assistant Tim Pickett testified on behalf of the medical efficacy of cannabis and the wide range of benefits it is having on his patients.
My youngest patient is 18 months old, managing a seizure disorder with his neurologist. My oldest patient is 98 years old, managing the end of life. I have IT professionals who are able to get back to work with PTSD after serving overseas. I have mothers and grandmothers who suffer from breast cancer who are now able to eat and watch their children and their grandchildren after taking cannabis as a medicine. These are not individuals living on the outskirts of our communities, they're individuals within our communities.
The men and women of the United States military have proven time and again that there is no task too small or mission too great. Will you support them in this cause?
Please sign the petition and let your representative and senator know that you stand with our troops and many other North Carolinians that are suffering and are seeking relief.